Someone making soup? Buddy, feeling good tonight? Give you that heart thing that they do. Yeah, and this. The rappers. Actually, if I was gonna do that, I'd probably do both at the same time, you know? Let's see, tonight I think I'll start off with a different song. I'd like to start off with a song from one of our office Christmas parties where Creed at the karaoke played this song here. I got a new take on it. To feel the magic, no one wants their happy endings to be tragic, no. It's hard believing in love. I was one of those afraid to be lonely, scared to believe and find my one and only love. Suddenly found.
Wow, wow.
Spinning and reeling with love. Whoa, come on, gang. Spinning and reeling with love. She kind of puts my head in gear. Such a turbocharged. So good, my feet don't touch the ground.
Wow, wow.
Spinning and reeling with love. Whoa, come on. Spinning and reeling with love. Everybody knows I'm crazy about you, baby. Just can't stop thinking about turbocharged affair. We're spinning and reeling, reeling and spinning, feeling like I did in the beginning. Please don't say this is ever ending, 'cause with you I was never pretending. Spinning and reeling with love. Whoa, come on. Spinning and reeling with love. You got me, whoa, 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 whoa. Thank you very much. Oh, oh. Before I go any further, I want to thank Jesus. Hernandez, who worked on my last special that I shot up in San Francisco. He worked craft service, did a marvelous job with his little finger foods. Thank you, Jesus. I've got a new CD coming out called While the Young Punks Dance, which will be out April 6th. Hope you all check that out on iTunes and other places like that. I'd like to do one of the songs from the aforementioned album called Ready For You Now. Hope you enjoy it. Talking to her Indonesian friends, it was driving us crazy because we couldn't communicate with this little boy. And she's not that nice of a person, to be very honest with you. Really not. Really not. So, and we were getting really, really tired. So one day I look up and I'm sitting at my desk. And by the way, for the first couple of years on that show, I actually thought I was working in a paper company. I didn't know it was a TV show. I thought I was getting paid pretty well. Didn't want to rock the boat. So I see Krasinski and Rainn Wilson talking to Phyllis Smith over the side in by Rainn's desk. I go, maybe they found out that I shouldn't be here, you know. I'm in the wrong place, obviously, you know. And she's going, know, and I'm going, what the hell are they doing? And so they Rain pushes Phyllis, and she walks, and Phyllis is very demure, really, she's a very, very shy lady, and she goes, Creed, yes, Phyllis, what is it? We were wondering, what, just speak up, Phyllis, what do you want? She said, well, John and Rain and I wanted to know if you could tell Angela to shut the fuck up. Because it was like, to hear her speak was like, you know, a drowning weasel in a sack. It's just like a slaughtered chicken kind of a sound. It was like, oh man, it was really hard. It wasn't pretty. Most people that speak the language sound fine. They do, but not Angela. So I said, done. So I'm thinking what I'll do is I'll write this song. And I will, you know, lure her in with an Indonesian song. I'll learn Indonesian for the song and sing it to her. And because I speak a lot of languages. She said, you speak a lot of languages. I said, yeah, yeah, so I'll do it. I found out that I don't write songs per se. They have to come to me through the channels that songwriters get through the muse. So I'm going along and I don't know what to say. So finally I have a song kind of about snakes, because I know there's poisonous snakes and rubber plants in Indonesia. And then somebody calls me and says something about politicians, and I put that in there. And then I put something about the down low, which I read about, I heard about in the Oprah show. So anyway, it's a real hodgepodge song, but here it goes. And if you want to sing along, it's the title song from, not the album that's coming out, or the album before, but this fifth solo album of mine called Bounce Back, and this is called Rubber Tree, all right? And I may ask you to sing along with it later. You know the song. And if you don't, then don't do it. You gotta wind it up, bounce back, do the rubber tree. You gotta wind it up, bounce back, do the rubber tree. In Indonesia, there's a thousand snakes that'll paralyze in a heartbeat. But out on the floor, they got a brand new dance that'll surely kill you, called the rubber tree. You gotta wind it up, bounce back, do the rubber tree. Politicians are like reptiles, amazing longevity. You cut off their heads, hey, it don't matter, they stay in office anyway. You gotta wind them up, or they'll bounce back, do the rubber tree. You gotta wind them up till they cool down, spring back the second time around. Wind them up till you cool down, spring back. Well, there's a smarty gentleman, he came into town without his family in tow. He sees a young blood in snakeskin boots, he's going down low. He's gonna wind him up, he'll bounce back, do the rubber tree. He's gonna wind him up, he'll bounce back, do the rubber tree. Now try this verse with me, just to say it. Be it hetero or homo or pericomo. Do you know who pericomo is?
Yeah.
Okay, a few. They're like my age, maybe not. Maybe your parents or grandparents. Your great-grandparents played that song, pericomo. Be it hetero or homo or pericomo, do the rubber tree. Why? Because of the last verse about the down low. See where I'm going with this? It's very contemporary. I hope with the political climate that I can get away with this right now, you know? That, thinking about that, too, if we were on The Office and Phyllis came in now on TV and said, oh my God, this guy just exposed himself to me out in the parking lot. And Creed goes, oh, he was just hanging brain. If that's a crime locking up, I don't think we would do it. I don't think we would try it right now. Okay, here we go. Try that. Be it hetero or pericomo, do the rubber tree. One, two, three. Be it hetero or homo or pericomo, do the rubber tree. And hate to yourself for this later. Me and Petro are home over Perry Como. Do the rubber big one tree. Nice. Very nice. It kind of goes in sipping. It really goes in sipping. Thank you. I think I'll do a grassroots song right now. Yeah, all right. The first big hit by the grassroots that I participated on was Let's Live for the Day, which I will perform later, because I'm starting to do more, because people keep saying, you gotta do your heritage. You know, the reason that you stayed alive all those years before the office came along is because you had that little glimpse of stardom with the grassroots. So, this song is written by P.S. Sloan. It's called Where Were You When I Needed You? And lest we forget, Creed is a rock star, you know? And I have the tattoos to prove it. Actually, I don't. I don't believe in them. That's not true either. I think they're kind of cool, but the time I really wanted to get one, I wanted to get one, rent this space on my forehead. I was getting too old. I went in and I was going to do something on my buttocks. And the guy said, man, he said, your skin's like parchment. He said, you're so old. He said, it's like drawing on wet paper. He said, it's tearing. I said, okay, never mind. Just don't bother. Don't bother. So, it's kind of embarrassing, but true. Discuss your faults. Okay, the song, Where Were You When I Needed You? The crawling, it's all over now, no use in store. The love I once felt, I don't feel anymore for you. This time I'll even open the door for you. While you walked out when I was down, now I'm well off, look who's coming round. I've already decided. Living with you is worse than without you. I won't spend a lifetime worrying about you. Our things got rough and you couldn't wait. Now you're tripping back, but girl, it's too late. Tripping back, babe, I'm not here. Where were you when I wanted you? Season 7 of The Office, Steve Carell left the show. Don't know what happened to his career after that, where he even turned out, you know, but I wish him well. Leave us like that. At the same time, we lost Greg Daniels, our showrunner, creator, well, the American creator of the show, and Mike Schur, who played Moe's, and they went on to start Parks and Rec. So I thought at the rap party I would write a little song called Moe's Was a Runner. Moe's, Mike was a showrunner. And again, as I told you before, every time I start this stuff, it's like 2 weeks, maybe 2 months later, getting close to the rap party, and I have no song. I got nothing. I got the title, Moe's Was a Runner. So I'm jogging up on Mulholland, close to where I was living at the time, and going, and I'm on the left side of the road, that's where you go because, you know, if you see a car coming out of control, get out of the way, don't get hit. Above me, on the road, on the right-hand side, with his back to the traffic, is this guy jogging along, brand new white jumpsuit, you know. He doesn't have a little ear, you know, like a phone in his little pouch or something to listen to. He's got full cans on his head, hooked with this big cable down to a reel-to-reel, look like. Probably it was a Walkman, it looked like just an old tape deck. And he was walking like a god, and I go, this guy, this is an accident waiting to happen. All of a sudden, around the corner, a brand new Cadillac Escalade comes. I see it in the back seat as it comes by. And everything's slowing down. You know when tragedy is about to happen, there's an emergency or a real tragedy, everything freezes. It's one of those situations. I looked, I see the two little spoiled Beverly Hills brats in the back seat, texting, petulant little whiny faces. In the front seat, the mom. She is driving with a wooden steering wheel with spokes on it. She's driving with her elbow like this. Left turn, right turn. Left turn, her hands free though, so she can look in the mirror while she's driving with her elbow, not joking, and do her hair and makeup like this. But her right hand is free. So if she's got a phone, she's texting too. I think the little bastard's in the back seat. That's what I'm thinking. So, and all of a sudden, I go and I see this occurring, and then I see the jogger, and she goes, and then the kids are fighting, and she turns around, you shut up, and bam! She hits the guy with a car. Big SUV. Oh, poor man. But great for my song. Because at that moment, I went, ah, I see what this puppy's about. So here it is. Moe's Was a Runner, and I might ask you to sing along, and you better do better than you did on that last song. That was pathetic. I came here tonight in a scooter, in this freezing cold, so, and I'm in my 70s now, so you can at least damn well sing along with me. Let me go. Okay, all right.
Please, hey, Mo, there you go, get out of the way.
coming, you play a losing game. If you can't see them coming, play a losing game. Ah. If you can't see it coming, you can't get out of the way. Hey, Moes, get out of the way. Big time, folks. Come on in here. Get Jesus had worked on my special in San Francisco. Well, when I went up there to shoot it, I walked from Los Angeles to San Francisco in lieu of taking the bullet train. Because, let me tell you, ever since that film came out, Stand By Me, I wanted to find a dead body of my own by the railway tracks. Closest thing I've come so far is this sweater here. Sometimes I can close my eyes and imagine that a bullet train knocked it off, a guy or a gal or some other type. That's pretty cool to think of that. Probably not though. Because I know the minute I get on that train, I'll be playing poker with some hustler. Do a podcast or having a little nosh or taking a nap, and we're going to speed right on by a dead body, and that'll be too late. Yeah, so I don't want that to happen. Here's a song from the next album again, so I'm priming the pump for this next album. This one's called Heart of Darkness, and it is about people who are searching for their soulmate in life. And they believe once they find that person or the girl or the guy, whatever, that their life's going to be fine. Now, I believe, and my friend Billy Harvey, who wrote the song with me, we believe that soulmates may come in just for a day, a week, a year, a month, to give you a spiritual information you need for your journey. It's all about the journey. It's all about finding who you are and what you've got to go with. And many, many times, you may have to cut these things short because it's just not right. And you have to go places that you're uncomfortable with, but that's just part of the deal, and you have to, you know, face up to it. So it's called Heart of Darkness, and I hope you enjoy it. Can I hear a little more in my monitor, please? That's good.
Because I walk with you
while you walk with me into the heart, into the heart of darkness, where it begins, everything changes in time. Moon and sun, a smoking gun, an empty stage, a fool's parade, 'cause I go where you go, into the heart. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I mentioned that I would do this other song by the Grassroots. Let's Live for Today, which was the first big hit for the Grassroots when I performed on with my buddy Warren Entner, and who I met in Israel when I was out of college, and I'd spent 2.5 years traveling around Europe, North Africa, and all over, went everywhere practically. Not the Orient, but most places, those, you know, through the Red Curtain countries and stuff, playing music. And when I got back and came to LA, I hooked up with Warren, who I'd met at a folk festival in Israel. And he had just got out of UCLA. Within a week, we had a band called The 13th Floor. And within a year of playing around the valley and on the strip and stuff, we became The Grassroots. It's our first big hit. It goes to number 5. And we're thinking, we're in our mid-20s. We're going, we're rock stars. Should have got the tattoos then. And then people start coming up to us in airports and stuff, saying, especially soldiers, and said, we were in Vietnam, and the song Live for Today got us through some really hard times. Because that's a great message, the song, it really does. And we're starting to think, damn, we're pretty cool. We start taking ourselves serious. Ubris, overweening pride. If you do, bring it right back down to terra firma. You gotta stay humble, folks. The old Creed tells you that right now. Be human. So, well, we were still rock stars. We're taking ourselves seriously. All of a sudden, this is what happened. Billboard magazine comes out with this article. I don't know why the guy wrote it. It says, regarding the hit song Let's Live for Today by the pop group The Grassroots, we assume this group is heterosexual. What? We were freaking out. And they said, because why the lyrics, baby, I need to feel you inside of me. Baby, I need to feel you deep inside of me, sung by men. We went, well, it's love. It's love. Now, Warren and I got it. We were fine. We'd been to Europe and college and stuff. We were a little more metro, you know. We were laissez-faire. We had the hunky huevos. Skip around the room. We were fine with it. But the other two guys were freaked out. Now, I gotta let you know, I did have a few little homophobic, you know, fears at the time. I kept having this reoccurring dream after the article of all my old girlfriends coming at me in a circle wearing these snap-ons. And it was horrifying. And a little titillating too, I have to say. So, but I'm over it now. I can sing the song without fear of getting weirded out by it, you know? Here it is. Let's Live for Today. I can get through this song. When I think of all the worries people seem to find, and how they're in a hurry to complicate their minds by chasing after money, dreams that can't come true. I'm glad that we are different. We've better things to do. May others plan their future. I'm busy loving you. 1, 2, 3, 4, sing it. Sha la 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 la. You don't know the song for today. Sha la 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 la. Live for today and don't worry about and I'm in no hurry. I'll take my time with you. We'll take it nice and easy and use my simple plan. You'll be my loving woman, I'll be your loving man. We'll make the most of living, have pleasure while we can. 2, 3, 4, sha la 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 la, live for today. Sha la 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 la, live for today. And don't worry about tomorrow. Hey, hey, hey. Smiling, and I'm not. The smug nods. I've got the smug nods, kind of like those dogs they used to have in the back seat of cars with the head. Okay, here we go. The part we were talking about, the aforementioned homophobic part. Which I'm cool with now. Really cool with it.
Sci-fi porno came up called Alien Penis, and in it there's this giant phallus that came down from the stars, and it was going over the suburbs outside, like right out here. You can just imagine just coming like this, and everyone was, what's it gonna do? We knew what the movie what it was gonna do, you know. And all of a sudden, these two big giant spaceships, round globes, came up and attached themselves to the base of the phallus, and. Again, lots of cleanup afterwards. So I was sick of these movies. I wasn't being fulfilled as an artist. Did one movie that I'm actually quite proud of, a porno noir. Mickey Spillane tribute called the Shalom Goodbye. So, I still get fan mail from that. All right, let's, you know what? I'm gonna do another grassroots song since we're on a roll with this stuff, okay? This is a grassroots song called Temptation Eyes. And I do it, obviously, you can see that I'm not approaching these songs in the conventional way. I'm more of the softer. You get this way when you get older because you have to slow down. Right there. Hold that up like this. so I can see it. And yeah, that's pretty good right there. Okay, that's good. Jenny, you've done this before, see? Not everyone can do this. I'm trying. Don't screw it up, Jenny. Don't shake. Just stand there. Breathe. A little bit like into the light, and okay, good. That's right there. It's perfect. Okay. You'll see what this is about once I get started. It's a brand new song. Hope you enjoy it. I think they will, Jenna Fisher. Isn't that a coincidence? The one girl I picked, the only Jenna in the whole audience. I'm going to this pretty soon. Let's start at the top with Michael Scott, played by Steve Carell, and he's pretty swell. We got Rainn Wilson, and he plays in his mustard suit. We love Jim, and which one's Pam, played by John Krasinski, and Jenna Fischer. We moved to accounting with Oscar, but he's not really gay. And Brian with his number 11, and Angela Kinsey, who's 3'11". Here we go. Ba-ba, ba-di-da-di-da. You know it. Sing it. Ba-ba-ba-di-da-di-da. Everybody. Ba-ba. You too, Jenna. Ba-da-da. Ba-ba-ba-di. Phyllis Smith was married to a Vance and Stanley with his eyes at half mast. And BJ and Mindy fought all the time. But David Denman, Jenna, only that one named Roy, if I can remember. We got Ed Helms with his banjo and Holly Black's wearing sandals and Toby and the minor chord, bad guy. Scranton Strangler. You know, Jenna, I was at that trial when Toby was up there testifying, and I was sitting out with the bereaved of the victims, you know, and the press and stuff like this. I had just come from that Halloween party. I had blood splatter on me, for God's sakes. And I'm staring at Toby, he's clueless. They got the wrong guy. One, two, here we go. Ba-ba, ba-di-da-di-da. Ba-ba-ba-di-da-di. Ba-ba, ba-di-da-di-da. Ba-ba-ba-di-da-di. Rashida Jones, James Spader, Kathy Bates, and Will Ferrell, Clark and Jake, and Idris Elba, Hacker and Jack Coleman, Nellie Kemper, Craig Robinson, Andy Buckley, and Zach Woods, Laura, Hugh Dana, Amy Adams, and Danny Cordray, played by Timothy. Timothy, of course, was on that great, classic, iconic show, Deadwood. We love that show. One of the best shows on TV. And then, of course, you might know him from Justified. For years on the show, I really wanted to be on that show. I practiced this line. I think I've got it down pretty good, Jenny. He goes, do we have a problem, Raylan? It would have worked. It should have been. What are you saying? One, two, three. Ba ba, ba di da di da. Ba ba, ba di da di. Ba ba, ba di da di da. Ba ba, ba di. Well, Meredith was a drunk and a slut, and that's a fact. 'Cause I sat next to her in the back, not ever sure if I got her in the sack, but she said I didn't. Let's see now, Jenna. Who did I forget? Oh yeah, well, it's not too late. Me and Mose and Catherine Tate. Ba ba, ba di da di da. Let's dance around now. Ba di da di da. Ba di da di da. died if I had a whole bunch of them. I should, you know what? Make a note, Mark. We should give them out. No, we won't do that.
What's this other one here?
What's this? Put out there. The what?
Review.
Oh, that's right. My first review. Mark surprised me tonight and said he got this review. No one ever reviews my shows. I don't know why. Come out in this lovely weather. All right, so we'll read it together for the first time. Be great, Mark. Need Jenna to do this. Okay. Tonight, Creed played the hits from his long-forgotten catalog. This almost adequate show gave phoning it in a new meaning. He set the bar just high enough with a lot of inside jokes that no one got. Wait. In all fairness, though, even though the show starts off slow, it really bogs down at the end. Yet, throughout the evening, he always seems pleased with himself for no apparent reason. You'll leave the show like me, confused and unfulfilled. Which apparently is just what he wants. Well, that's right, exactly. He understands me. That's exactly. I got my point across. This is good. It's a good thing. Yeah. It's an honest review. You can see how the show is going. A little bit of levity in between.
Yeah.
Then the songs. These songs were my plans. Because I'm basically Creed is a sad man. It's just the way it is. The humor, laugh, clown, laugh, just covers up all this stuff. They think I'm kidding. But that's the way it is. You know, that's the way, a lot of funny people are that way. But the point is that I do have the stuff in between. But the songs, it comes out of my songs. When I'm doing an acting, I can be funny. You know, that's good. That's a fun thing. But they always say, write about what you know. And since Creed was a real bad boy during the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, and you did a lot of crazy things. This song I wrote for a dealer friend of mine who died recently. And he helped a lot of people in LA. He was a good guy. That was just his job, you know. Called Boxer in the Club. Hope you enjoy it. Thank you. God's on his side. He's got a monkey on his back. He's that old beach bum. Deals out of Baton Rouge. Sad moment. But months before, I got a knock on my trailer door on the set, and it's a PA giving me some information. Now, Rain Wilson and I both had the PAs trained not to make eye contact with us. They had to look down at, like a lot of people do that in Hollywood, you know, but we were vehement about enforcing that. And he said, Mr. Bratton, I said, speak up. I said, Mr. Bratton, I said, not so loud. And then when he got a ride, I said, what do you want? Little shit, you know. I said, Greg wants to see you in his office. I said, well, why don't you say so? Shove him out of the way and trip around the room up there to him, you know. And what is it, boss? And he said, well, we're going to end the show pretty soon. We're asking information. This is unprecedented in Hollywood that the showrunner is asking the cast input on how they want to end the show with their character. I mean, these people were so much love, and I really truly feel so blessed and privileged to have been on that show and to get that opportunity. It was an amazing thing, and even got better during the finale because he said, well, what do you want to do? And I said, well, I have this song called All the Faces, and I wrote this right after I left the Grassroots. I'm sitting in my house in Ramirez Canyon in Malibu. My little baby, Mommy, was just born. She was in the bassinet there. I'm by the fire playing my guitar. My wife's in the kitchen, where a woman belongs. What? Oh, okay, I cook and I change diapers. Come on, I do. No, I did. So. I'm sitting there playing my guitar, and all of a sudden, there's this thing happening. Like I told you before, I can't sit down and write a song per se, but if I'm not thinking, the muse comes courting, and all of a sudden, lyrics, guitar, melody, all at once. Did the whole thing, and this song just pops right out through the ether. And I heard her say, that's beautiful. Who wrote it? And I said, I think I just did. So I tell Greg, and he said, well, that sounds interesting. What do you want to do with the song? And I said, well, I'd like to put it, you know, in where I'm singing at Poor Richard's, up on stage, and all the cast members come through at the end of the show, and they walk through, and the camera catches their faces while I'm singing All the Faces. He said, let me hear the song. So I tell the little shit to go get my guitar, and he brings it back, and he almost drops it because he's so nervous, you know, which amuses me to no end. It's not my guitar. It was the one they gave me. So otherwise, I wouldn't have him do it. So I know I don't hear anything more about it. Next thing I know, we're doing the table read for. Table read is when you sit around a big room and the cast is there and they read the script for the very first time. So reading the finale, it's very emotional. And we're in a big room, there's cameras there, the press is there, and all the brass is from NBC and Reveille and the media. And right at the end of the script, it says, Creed sings his song, All the Faces. I almost started crying. I went, oh, and I had to look down and kind of steel my nerves so I wouldn't cry, because I was like, oh my God, they're going to let me sing my song in the finale of this show I love so much. So I sang it at the table read, and people were visibly moved. I mean, these suits, and these people eat their own, for God's sakes, you know? They're getting emotional with it too. So I want to say, you have been a lovely audience. I hope you enjoyed my songs. And I'd love to spend the time with you. Here it is for you. For you. The song, this is how I end the show. And this is how The Office ended, with this song, All Faces. I saw a friend today, it had been a while, and we forgot each other's names, but it didn't matter, cause deep inside, the feeling still remained the same. We talked of knowing one before you met, and how you feel more than you see, and other worlds that lie spaces in between, and angels you can see, and all the faces that I know have that same familiar glow. I think I must have known them somewhere once before, all the faces that I know.
Get home.